Now I wanted to create a little bit of a different type of video here. I wanted to get over by the window here because it's finally spring outside. It's beautiful. We've gone through this horrific winter, this terrible, disgustingly horrific winter here in Boston. It's really funny because you see people come outside and they're coming out of their holes and they're squinting at the sun because they forgot their sunglasses and they're finally getting that vitamin D that we all definitely need. Now spring really is personally my favorite time of year, and for thousands of years spring has always represented kind of a rebirth, an awakening, especially after a really, really long bad winter like what we just had. And now that the winter is changing, I wanted to create a video specifically about that very thing, about change. And since I help women, of course, with their dating lives, this video will be focused specifically on how to change or transform your dating life if you're not happy with it today. Because many of you might be stuck in like that dating winter, that horrible place that you want to get out of. And if that's the case, I ask that you watch every single minute of this video. I ask that you watch every single second of this video because it might just be the video that helps you just instantly begin transforming your love life. But in order to be able to transform your love life, you need to actually learn how to change. I mean, learning to change in itself is really a skill. Now the real reason I've found that most people fail to change and transform their love life is because they are just too stubborn or too afraid to just try new things or new ideas. Let me tell you something, the more adaptable you are, the quicker that you will see results in anything that you do. And quite frankly, I have never coached anyone in my entire life who didn't have to change a part of who they are in order to be successful in finding or keeping love. Improvement really does require change sometimes. Maybe you need to change how it is that you talk to yourself, your inner dialogue. I mean, are you unforgiving? Are you tough? Are you critical towards yourself? Are you spiteful? Are you even hateful? Imagine if you could change that conversation that you have in your own mind, if you could change that to self-love, acceptance, and openness towards yourself. How might that help you attract great people into your life? I mean, maybe you need to change how it is that you speak to others. I mean, do you talk down to people? Are you maybe kind of depressing to be around? Are you a little bit pretentious when you talk to people? I mean, or are you a little bit shy or overly shy in any social situation? Or are you just always trying to prove yourself or always seeking validation in every situation? I mean, imagine if you could just change a little bit about how you communicate with others. Just by trying to be genuinely more inquisitive, more caring about them, be more positive about your life and other people's lives. I mean, imagine if you could start really just listening to what other people have to say rather than always trying to do the talking. How might that attract new guys into your life? Maybe you need to change your expectations of men and love. I mean, do you have this belief that if you're not married by the age of 27 or by the age of 30, that you're a complete failure and that no one would be attracted to you? That's crazy. I mean, maybe you need to change the guys that you're going for. Maybe you only invest yourself in guys who are totally emotionally unavailable because you find them to be the biggest challenge and you're really into them. Or maybe are you only attracted to men that put you down or quote unquote a challenge, but at the end of the day, it causes you pain and frustration. I mean, if we really get to the core of what it is that I do here at Sexy Confidence, at the end of the day, I help women feel great about themselves, and I help them feel great about themselves through the constant pursuit of change and improvement in their lives. I mean, I ask that you experiment with new thoughts, new ideas, new actions, new conversations, new types of men, new types of guys that you hang out with, new venues, a new sense of self, a new sense of confidence. But let me tell you something, it is impossible to help anyone change if they don't want it. So let's say you are now ready to make a change in your love life. You're ready to transform. Let me tell you something, change really only happens in three ways. One is that you finally have reached your lowest standards. I mean, maybe you've decided that you've just had it. You are tired of being alone. You want to make a change. Or maybe you've been dating a guy that you've been seeing for a little bit, but finally he, for the fourth time, he cancels on you last minute and you say to yourself, you know what, screw him. I am done. I'm going to make a change. And you know what? In order to keep facilitating this type of change in your life, all I ask that you do is keep raising your standards and be amazed when men respond to meet them. Number two is that you get inspired by something. You realize that your actions just aren't making you happy and you need to do something about it. Now, this might happen from watching some sappy movie that hits you on a very emotional level. Maybe it's like The Notebook or something like that. Or maybe it's just from watching this video. This hit you and you said, you know what, now it's time to change my life. But anyways, you need to find something that is going to hit you on an emotional level that says, hey, this inspires me. I am now ready to get out there and make a serious change in my own life. Or the third way is you simply just make a choice to change. For most people, if you're not used to making changes in your life, just simply choosing to make a change is a little bit more difficult. But the interesting thing is, the more often that you change and the more often that you improve yourself, the more you get comfortable with change, the more you get comfortable with different things in your life. And then finally, you will get to a point, if you change enough, you'll get to a point in your life where you are so in control of your life that you can simply just make a conscious choice, and voila, then you've changed all your behaviors, you've changed your life. It can be that simple. Now I want to talk a little bit about the power of elasticity. Now, if we look at a rubber band, it fits pretty much around anything we want. It's flexible, it's fun to play with, it's fun to shoot at people, of course. Now I want you to look at your behaviors just like a rubber band. Either you can sit still right here and just have the same shape and just do whatever it is that you do in your own life, or you can start learning how to stretch your comfort zone a little bit and start embracing change and start to see what works for you. Open your mind to new experiences. Allow yourself to be vulnerable again. Stretch your social comfort zone a little bit. Say hello to someone that you would have never talked to previously. Wear some outfit that might be a little bit ridiculous, might stretch your social comfort zone a little bit, but you know what? Hey, I'm gonna go for it. Go to a singles event. That might make you a little nervous. You're thinking, why am I going to a singles event? But go for it. Be a little bit more sarcastic on your next date, because you know what? Previously you've been a little bit more reserved, but hey, give it a shot. See how it goes. And you know what? See how he responds. Or maybe you have to confront that guy that you've just been like hooking up with, that he's clearly only using you for sex. You know what? Have that conversation. Tell him that you're not interested in just that and that you want more. All that I ask of you is to constantly strive to improve through the act of change. And now that spring is finally upon us, now is the time to change. And I'm sorry, if you're watching this video in the Southern Hemisphere or Australia or South America, and it's starting to go into winter right now, you know what? Or maybe you're watching this at another time of year, still, now is the time to change. Because maybe you need to redefine yourself. Maybe you need to redefine who you are socially. Maybe you need to redefine your identity. Or maybe you just need to simply start removing yourself from toxic people. Do what needs to be done in order to get that ball rolling. I mean, maybe change in your love life needs to begin with change in other areas of your life. Maybe you've been drinking too much and it's making you a little depressed. Maybe you've been eating too much sugar at night, and trust me, I'm totally guilty of this as well. But maybe you're eating too much sugar and it's causing you to gain weight on a regular basis. Maybe you just absolutely hate your job and it's causing you to just lose all of your energy. Or maybe you're just finding that you're kind of mean to people, and you don't mean to be mean, it's just something that just happens because things aren't going great in your life and you just can't seem to help it. And regardless, true happiness really does come from self-discovery and from change. And you really won't know exactly what shape is really right for you and what feels right and who you really are unless you are elastic. So the question is, how do you commit to making that change in your love life? First off, you must answer one very important question, and that is the question of why. Why is this change important to you? Maybe it's to pursue a new happiness. Maybe it's to avoid sadness in your life because you're lonely. Maybe it's both. I mean, why do you really want a relationship? Why is it important to you? Why is it important for you to go to every single party that you get invited to? Why is it important to go to that singles event that makes you a little bit nervous? Why are you going to start smiling at a guy when you see him from across the room? I mean, this is where the question of why is very important. Because that why, knowing the answer to that why, is going to keep you on track when you do inevitably hit a roadblock that kind of sets you back a little bit. Number two is to start small. Small steps start to produce that momentum for you to take larger steps in your life. I mean, as my dad always says, how do you eat an elephant? You eat it a bite at a time. If you haven't been on a date, let's say, for a few years or a year or even a few months, then maybe you might just want to take one small step right now and sign up for an online dating site. Just get that profile rolling. Maybe you've been going out on a lot of dates. You've decided, you know what, this weekend I am going to go out and just have fun for myself. Take one small step in order to start building that momentum for change. The third one is get support. I mean, everyone needs support in our lives, and you must have support in order to make any major change. We all need someone who believes in us and our own ability to change. And if you do have someone that supports you and regularly supports changes you make in your life, go ahead and tell them. Tell them about what change you're gonna make in your life right now. And unfortunately, if right now you don't have that person in your life, then you know what? Here's what I need you to do. start supporting other people unconditionally in their own lives and be amazed when they start supporting you. Start getting out there, find that support system. It's really important. Number four is figuring out the how. How are you going to actually make this change? I always believe in finding a mentor who's got a great track record for helping other people change in the same way that you want to change. In your love life, of course, I mean, I have programs at sexyconfidence.com that help women transform their love life. If it's another area of your life, of course, find a different mentor for that area of your life. And lastly, number five is it's really, really important that you set your expectations. You need to realize that positive change doesn't always happen in an instant. It's not going to happen immediately. And sometimes you'll be taking one step backwards in order to take two steps or three steps forwards. For example, let's say that you decided that you're going to break it off with this guy because he is not meeting the standards that you've set for yourself, or he's bringing you down, or he's not treating you well. Well, at first, once you break it off with him, maybe you might feel worse and you might regret that change. But you know what? In 2 months, once you start to get a little bit more aware, start meeting new people, start enjoying yourself, you're going to feel great. You're going to take those two, three steps forward in your life. So here's what I ask you to do. Please make a change, any change right now. Choose one critical aspect of who you are that you want to change. And if you can't decide which one to hone into because you have a lot that you've decided that you want to make some major change in your life, then here's what I recommend you do. I recommend that you brainstorm all of the changes on one sheet of paper. And then find the one thing, the one change that is going to have the most dramatic impact on the happiness in your life. And choose that one thing. Because remember, change does take very specific focus. So please don't try to do too much at once. And once you've honed in on that particular change that you want to make, I want you to answer this one question. Why is this change important to you? Then I want you to think to yourself, what is one tangible action that you can take immediately? And I don't mean in a few hours, certainly not in a few days. I mean immediately after you finish watching this video. Take that specific action. Get the ball rolling. Remember, it's all about small steps. And then once you take that small step, I want you to call your support system. Tell that person that you're going to make this change in your life. Explain to them why it's important. And just ask them that you're looking for that unconditional support because of how important this change is in your life. And then it's the fun part, discovering the how. I mean, how are you going to do this? And assuming this is a change in your love life, definitely head on over to sexyconfidence.com. We have a ton of resources there that are going to help you specifically, step by step, make these types of changes in your life. And if the change is outside of your dating life, that's fantastic as well. Definitely find some mentor who can help you, who has a step-by-step proven system that's going to help you through this area of your life. Maybe it's a business coach, maybe it's a personal trainer, whatever it is, find someone who can be that mentor to teach you the how. And lastly, please set your expectations and create a realistic time frame of how long it will take you to finally achieve this change in your life. Because again, sometimes it might require one step backwards in order to take two steps forward. So please follow this video, make that change today, immediately, right after this video, follow the steps and become that person who's very open to change. So thank you so much for watching this video. This has actually been a very different style video. I actually tried shooting it on my roof deck, but it started to rain. So thank you again for watching. And if you enjoyed it, please give it a like on YouTube. I really appreciate that. And definitely subscribe on YouTube, wherever that is. And definitely don't forget to head on over to sexyconfidence.com, where I have a ton of other videos just like this. I'll speak to you soon. Thanks so much for watching.